Namo Buddhaya. The meritorious event of Shraddha Abhayadana, conducted at Gateway College, Nigambo, on 16th July 2016, to mark the 20th anniversary. May all rejoice in this meritorious event.
In fact, the entire Gateway school network, and what a great act. I could see the happiness in everyone's face.
We felt that is the most appropriate thing to invoke blessings to us, to the children, to everybody, the country, the leaders, everyone, with this such a beautiful spiritual program.
People from the international schools. I'd like other schools to see this and to like do this because it really is a nice experience.
I feel very happy because they are so cute and we have gained merits. I'm so proud and we are so happy.
After 20 years we have done a very good thing and I'm very proud to be a part of it and I'm very happy.
Namo Buddhaya. A very good morning to everyone who is joining with us in Gateway College. The chief guest today, Ms. Alice, and also the parents, dear Mahasangha, first of all. The parents and all other guests who are joining with us. First of all, I would like to start like this. Well, it's a great honor for myself because presenters normally don't get a chance, or rather TV presenters don't get a chance on presenting in these prestigious, in these meritorious events. Presenters normally get a chance, or rather TV presenters get a chance to present only in, or rather in TV, rather in a musical show, like that. So first of all, I would like to thank the Mahamyona Monastery of Kaduwela and ShraddhaTV for giving me this chance. Right. Assume someone comes and tell you, my dear, you will live only for another hour. Let's say it's a cancer patient. Yeah, someone comes and tells, my dear, your life is finished from another hour. You're gonna leave us. What will you think? What will come to your hearts? What will come to your hearts? All the good deeds you did, enjoying the life moments, past memories, everything will come to the life. everything will come to the heads? Or rather, ayyo aparadini thavadayak inna bæne mata. I have so much of duties. Yeah, those things will come to the mind. The objective of the Abhayadana program is to mark the 20th anniversary of Gateway College in a worthiest and noblest manner, freeing some innocent animals distinct to that. I now hand over the microphone to the Mahasangha to carry on with the further proceedings. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
So before we start the program, let's observe five precepts, venerate the triple gem. So let's venerate the triple gem together with me to observe five precepts. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Dutiyampi buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Dutiyampi dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Dutiyampi sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Tatiyampi buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Tatiyampi dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Tatiyampi sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. So I observe the precept of abstaining from killing beings. I observe the precept of abstaining from stealing. I observe the precept of abstaining from sexual misconduct. I observe the precept of abstaining from telling lies. I observe the precept of abstaining from taking intoxicating drinks and drugs. I follow these precepts for happiness in this life, for rebirth in heaven, and to realize the Four Noble Truths in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
So children, did you all see the animals? Did you all
see how it difficult was to get them. You also? No. Your teachers and the monks who went to get them, they know. They saw how difficult it was. In the morning, we went to the slaughtering house to get these small goats. There were around 20 animals. And we had money for only 10 animals. And it's a monk is going to clear these animals, to release these animals. I told them to separate 10 animals to a different chamber. Then they separated 10 animals. Then after that I told them, please calculate, let me know the price. After we calculated, the price was 1,58,000 rupees. The money that we had was, I think, 1 lakh, around 100,000, 10,000 rupees. Well, what would have happened now? The animals has been transferred to a different chamber. 11 animals. We have around 100,000, 10,000 rupees, 110,000 rupees. And now we are already separated. Now what would you do? If you all were there, you would have called your parents. Myself, whom would have called? We have given our lay lives. We have given up the homely life and now we have become monks. If I would have remembered the principal, I would have called her immediately. If I could remember her earlier, I would have called and informed, I need some extra money to save these animals. I forgot that. Then there was a friend of mine, he gave some extra money and we told change animals, no, there's no alternative. I told get the big ones and get some small animals. Then we change the big ones and we got the small ones back to 11 animals. Then there was a friend, he also participated in Abhedana and we escaped the 10 animals. We rescued the 10 animals. Then there was another 10,000 short, I think. Then I called the principal. Madam, there's 10,000 short. But then by the time, animal has been changed. Now see the nature of life, children. Who's bad karma? My bad karma or those animals' bad karma? Huh? Animals' bad karma. If I could remember the principal when I was in the chamber, I would have immediately called her. Then I would have got the approval and I would have saved those big ones. I could not remember. I didn't have the mindset to call and ask. But at the initial stage, when the big ones were separated to the other room, if I would have remembered her, I would have get them. But I couldn't do that. I did not get the message from the mind. Now we do things when we get a message from the mind, isn't it? Yeah. But I didn't get the message. So only the meritorious animals from that set, from that group, were released. So dear children, we should be very glad. Why? We were born as human beings. In this very life, in this life, we were not born as animals. We were not born as the fish in the sea. We were not born as demons. We were not born as ghosts. If we were born as animals in this life, don't you think the same thing would have happened to us? The same thing. Could be something worse than that would happen to us. But temporarily, we are escaped. For how many years? 100 years, 200 years? No, just for 60, 70 years, we are temporarily saved as human beings. But is this life permanent or impermanent? Impermanent. Very good. Impermanent means what? Impermanent means after we finish our lifespan. Let's say a person is supposed to live for 60 years or 55 years. After he finishes his lifespan, he has to die. Now, after that person dies, where will he be born in next birth? That depends on the realization of a Supreme Buddha's Dhamma. That depends to the true nature of this world. That depends on what you have done by body, speech and mind. That was preached by a great person who appeared to this world around 2,500 years ago. A prince who was born in a palace, left the palace, gave up a family life of a royal family, who was supposed to become a king to the whole of India. He gave up the life as a prince and became a recluse. He went on find for the truth in this world. And he realized this world as impermanent, which we don't understand. Now, why do we suffer, dear children? We lament, we cry. When the body changes, our mind also changes. When the body changes, our mind changes. When we go through sad feelings, when we go through fearful feelings, what happens to the mind? The mind also gets sad and fearful. Why is that? That's because we try to keep this world under our control. But is this world under our control? No, this world is beyond our control. Supreme Buddha preached, if somebody can understand this life is impermanent. Now this eye, what you see, your eyes, even my eyes, this is permanent or impermanent? Impermanent. These ears, impermanent or impermanent? Impermanent. The nose, permanent or impermanent? Impermanent. The tongue, body, mind, is all impermanent. If something is impermanent, if something is impermanent, it is subjected to happiness or suffering. When something is impermanent, that is subjected to suffering or to happiness. Why is subjected to suffering? Because we don't like to see this body is changing. When the body changes, we feel sad. But when you know yourself, earlier itself, this body is impermanent, the external world is impermanent. When you know earlier itself, when the body is changing, when you see this body is changing, when the whole world is changing, will you regret? No, you can tolerate. That's because you have a prior idea about the true nature of this world. That was preached by your Supreme Buddha. So one day, when Supreme Buddha was dwelling at Savatthi in India, he addressed the bhikkhus. Supreme Buddha said, "Dear bhikkhus, it is difficult to find a person who has not been a mother in the previous births." Now, didn't you have a previous birth? You were born, isn't it? Now, what happened to your parents? Where are they? What happened to your grandparents? In the previous births? Supreme Buddha preached, "We have been coming in an endless journey of births and deaths. The amount of tears we have shed when our parents passed away, when our children passed away, the amount of tears that we have shed is more than the four great oceans." And also Supreme Buddha preached, when we were born as goats and cows and hens, when we were being slaughtered, the amount of blood that we have shed is more than the four great oceans, dear children. Isn't it true? It's true. And if we were to go in future in this endless journey, what will happen to us? the same thing, something more than that will happen to us. So to give a full stop to this sansara, to this birth, to this endless births and deaths, we need this Abhedani program. When you give life to animals, you'll have long lifespan. Accidentally, let's say due to some mistake that you've done in the previous births or in this life, if you were born in animal world, won't you be escaped like this in future births? Somebody will escape you, like we do it now, like we did today. That assurance you'll get only if you do this kind of programs. So that's what you call abstaining from killing living beings and giving life to others. And Supreme Buddha preached, it's difficult to find in this world, it could be this monk or this monk, anybody in front of me, it's difficult to find a person who has not been a mother for that person in a previous birth. It's difficult to find this person is not a father for me in a previous birth. This person is not a brother. This person was not my brother. This person was not my sister. This person was not my nephew. Supreme Buddha preachers, it's difficult to assign such thing. That means we have saved these animals. They could be your earlier parents. They could be your relatives. You should be happy, dear children. But the happiness now they have got, can they develop wholesome deeds like you all? Can they escape from that animal world? No. But you have that opportunity. We gave them a very small chance to overcome from sadness. A small chance. A small opportunity. But you don't have that danger. You have the opportunity after your death can be born in a divine world. Or else you, in this life itself, to the endless journey of births and deaths, you can make it at least to seven lives and attain Nibbana. That is what you call becoming a stream entrant, a Sotapanna, disciple of Supreme Buddha. So be happy, dear children. We are very fortunate. We were able to develop wholesome deeds. That's why we got a human life, not just to learn, just to earn and live and just to die. The money, the properties, the wealth, nothing can be taken to the next life. Now, did these animals bring their previous wealth to this life? No. Same way, we won't be able to carry our wealth to our next birth. Only the wholesome deeds, what Supreme Buddha preached, that could help us to be born in a good destination. So, dear children, our Nalina, he explained a lot about Abhedana. And so, from my end, I tried to explain something from the Supreme Buddha's discourses. That is, in brief, we have been coming in endless journey, in endless births and deaths, and we were animals in previous births, and this could be our relatives, and we have saved them, and by giving life to them, we got long lifespan, and we protected one precept. So, at home, or in the school, you had to protect the other four precepts. What are the other four precepts? Abstaining from stealing, abstaining from misbehaving, abstaining from telling lies, being honest. And after you grow older, we should not drink. The ones who took alcohol, that's what has happened to them. Now they're animals. The ones who told lies, the ones who lied to others, the ones who engage in sexual misconduct, the ones who steal, the ones who kill living beings, now they are suffering. This is not the first and the last time they're going to be animals. It could be 1,000 times they'll be slaughtered like this. It could be even 200 times they could be slaughtered like that. That's their bad karma. That's the Supreme Buddha's realization. So dear Dhamma friends, meritorious children, from the merits we gather today by releasing these cows and these small goats, these animals, may gods, Brahmas, Nagas rejoice in these merits. May they develop in divine happiness. And may they protect us. May they help the Gateway College to develop. And may they help the teachers and students to develop in their future career. And may everyone be blessed by Devas and Brahmas, and may all Devas and Brahmas and Nagas realize the noble Dhamma in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation, sad, sad, sad. And may Mr. R.I.T. Alas rejoice in these merits. And may all the dead relatives rejoice in these merits. May they be well and happy and realize the noble Dhamma as soon as possible. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. And may all, and especially Director Harsh Alas and the distinguished guests and Mrs. Rohini Alas, Mr. Hiran Alas, and all the family members, all the teachers, especially the principal, very helpful. And I'm really thankful to her to giving us the opportunity to spread the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma to these children. And organizing these events, and Ms. Ruvantika and all the Buddhist teachers, and all the parents who participated in this program, and the children. May everyone here have the opportunity to realize the good Dhamma. May you all have long life. If you have long life, you can develop more wholesome deeds. You'll have the opportunity to do more good things when you have a long lifespan. And with the merits, with the power of these merits, may you have the opportunity to make your good dreams come true. May all your good dreams come true and realize this good Dhamma in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. May our teacher Lokasamin Mahansa, Kiribagura Jnana the Mahathera, Aludini Subodhi Thero, the chief monk of Kaduwela Mahamunava Meditation Monastery, advice of Shraddha TV, and all the respected Mahasangha who participated in this program, and monks in Sri Lanka and in all over the world. May all the monks rejoice in these merits. May they be well and happy. May they have long life and realize this good Dhamma in this Gautama Buddha's dispensation. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Bhavatu sabba mangalan rakkantu sabba devata Sabba Buddhanu Bhavene Sada Sati Bhavantute Bhavatu Sabba Mangalan Rakkantu Sabba Devata
Chairman of this international school, as a big entrepreneur, how do you feel about this prestigious event which happened today in the DLP College of Nigambu?
I think it's one of the greatest days at the DLP College Nigambu, in fact the entire DLP school network, because this is the first time we've been involved in an Abhaya Dana, and I myself experienced it for the first time, and what a great act, I think, for our children. I think you've given us the opportunity, especially the Mahamayuna temple. We are so thankful and grateful to you all for providing us with this opportunity, because this wasn't an act put together by the principal, the teachers, parents, and the students. I could see from the very first day when the idea was planted, from then on, there is so much enthusiasm in the school, and And today being the final day where the Abhaya Dana was carried out, I could see the happiness in everyone's face, and I think that brings joy to every one of us.
Right. Once again, now this is an international school. Yourself, the principals, the teachers, the students have all together done this program. There are other international schools also in this country which is running as the same, rules and regulations and so on. What is your message to the children out there? Because you are Sri Lankan, you are a very good entrepreneur once again. What is your message to all the children of the international schools out there?
Well, we have to remember that international school is also another school. I think the mere word international shows that we do an international curriculum. But that does not mean that we do anything in an international manner. We are very local, we are very Sri Lankan. And Sri Lankans are known to be people who are very hospitable, who take a special interest in giving. And in that respect, I think Abhaya Dana is very special. If you just see the happiness in the kids of this school, that shows that we are doing something right. So where our gateway is concerned, we are an international school, all right, but we are very Sri Lankan, and we in fact refer to ourselves as an international school in a Sri Lankan environment. Our founder, Mr. R.I.P. Alice, had equal emphasis on academics and sports, as well as the values and the culture of the school. The ethos of the school is to bring these children up as true Sri Lankan citizens. We are a multicultural organization. Yes, today maybe there may be predominantly the Buddhists, but there are also children from other religions, other beliefs. But when it comes to acts of this nature, we are just one family, and that's what makes us happy.
Good morning to you. Previously, Dr. Arshad has mentioned there are no more international, it's just the international name, but still, there are Sri Lankans. What is your thought? What is your thought in such meritorious actions happening in this particular school?
Actually, this is Gateway is an international school in a Sri Lankan environment. So we have to adhere to our values, and we are Sri Lankan. At the helm, the directorate, Sri Lankan, and we are Sri Lankan. So as educationists, we believe values are the most important thing that has to be given when the knowledge is always available. And now the newer system, newer thing that the students are doing is they are processing that knowledge, learning it. And the thing that has unchanged is values that has to be given. That is our duty as teachers, as educationists, to give to our children those values. And I'm so happy and proud today to be able to give that opportunity to my children at Gateway College. And I felt a dream that this is very important as Sri Lankans, that we all schools have these values given to our, inculcated to our children. That is the base for their foundation of life. That's the base. We felt that is the most appropriate thing to invoke blessings to us, to the children, to everybody, the country, the leaders, everyone, with this such a beautiful spiritual program. We are educationists, but we also think this is their second home and we are the parents. So we all take that role very seriously. And we give our children the direction from values, education, then let them learn it, process their knowledge, because we don't have to keep knowledge now. It's all available in the internet. What we are doing is giving that skill, processing, learning, processing the learning, that skill we are developing. Most important thing what we are doing in concurrently is that values. And as parents of their parents, in this family, everybody participated. Every single student, every parent participated. And today evening we are having the Pirit ceremony. As one family, they come together when we have such religious activities. That's the way at Gateway College.
Today, in this meritorious deed from Gateway College, this person was such a big backbone to all these meritorious actions which happened today. She is a Buddhist teacher, the Buddhist society teacher who teaches Buddhism language in the Gateway College. Welcome you, madam. How do you feel as a Buddhist teacher, being a Buddhist, being in an international school? What's your impressions? What other impressions are you getting in your heart right now?
I'm very proud. I feel proud within my heart. I have happiness because I don't think that this will happen in every international school. We got this rare opportunity because of our headmistress, to tell you the truth. Because usually in the international schools, according to my knowledge, we don't do such things. I have not witnessed so many things, but this time I think we did something really, really impressive, very blissful, and it's a big blessing for the whole school, and such a happiness that I have within my heart. After 20 years, we have done a very good thing, and I'm very proud to be a part of it, and I'm very happy.
Good morning. You're the head girl, isn't it? What's your name?
Kaduwela.
Kaduwela. Being the head girl, representing the entire school, representing your prefect guild, what do you feel when you do such meritorious actions in an international school?
Personally, I felt like it was a wonderful experience to see all those animals. I personally, alongside my prefects, got to go in to feed those animals, and it was nice to see that they were relaxed, and it was nice to know that they wouldn't have to face that, you know, what would happen in the slaughterhouse if we weren't to rescue them. And on behalf of the whole school, I feel really, really glad that we did this, and I'd like to thank our madam, Mrs. Dale, for all this and all that the Gateway schools. And being from the international school, I'd like other schools to see this and to like do this, because it really is a nice experience. And it's, even though I'm not a Buddhist, like even other religious people from other religions, it's just nice to know that we've helped these animals to be wouldn't know what they would have otherwise faced.
There were other students that were present here today. There were things like applicants, and there were younger students, many from like the primary stage. I'd like, they saw what I witnessed. I'm pretty sure they felt what I felt, and I'd like them to go and tell the other students that are not in the Buddhist religion, and to spread the message of what it felt like. And I'd like them to go on to the community and express what they felt, so that the whole community of Nigambo and perhaps more can know what it's like to do such a wonderful and meritorious act.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What's your name?
I'm Sonara.
Where are you from?
I'm from Nigambo.
What's your school?
Gateway College.
Sure?
Yeah.
Is it an international school?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Because
it says so.
Yeah.
Right. How do you feel about today? How about the animals you feel? What are your feelings?
I feel very happy because they are so cute, and this Gateway College has been made a big program to save and rescue these small animals. They are very proud, and I saw a cow being a pregnant. If they have been killed, there are two lives being killed. So we have rescued that much, and we have gained merits. I'm so proud, and we are so happy.
See, being a very small child, she expressed her feelings in such a manner. We all felt it. Thank you so much, Sonara, for joining us. So, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Being for us, you're a foreigner. But for Gateway, she is a parent. How do you feel Sri Lanka, being Sri Lankans, your son hopefully is studying Gateway, being another religion, how do you feel Gateway International School doing such meritorious feats?
I think it's a wonderful experience for children. It's certainly a new experience for me. I didn't even know that this was something that was possible. I think it's a really wonderful way for children to learn about compassion and learn about loving kindness towards other beings. So I think it's a wonderful eye-opener, and I'm very, very happy that Gateway has provided this opportunity for the children to learn, and the parents, certainly me.
Right. The first question I asked you before the recording was from which country you're from. She's from the United Kingdom. What's your message to the children out there who's watching us today, who will be watching us in the future? What's your message for the international students, for the overseas students out there?
I think my message is just take every opportunity that is given to you, and not to be closed, because it's so easy to be closed and be judgmental and have fixed ideas, and to just stay open and stay open to new beliefs. Take something from every opportunity, every religion, every person you meet, every experience is an opportunity to learn, and not just in an academic sense.
I had an interview with the chairman, the principal, now a parent, and the other generation is coming. This generation is a grandparent. What's your idea in such meritorious deeds which happen in your school?
As a grandmother, I always thought about, and I still am, and always I thought about and thinking that our children must behave, learn to behave well. And the discipline, we need to be disciplined with them. You can't build up them without religion. Religion is the most important thing that these children can learn many things and easily learn, and a lot of people are there to teach. This is, I think, a very good thing for children to learn about the fear, pain, and all these things that people, human beings and animals are facing.
So I have with me the people who the animals are being given to for their rest of the life to be looked after and to be fed and to look and to give them the best protection in the best, utmost best they can. I would like to talk with him. Hi, thank you. ඕගලන් කරන්නේ සතු ටික අපි බාර දුන්නේ ගේට්වේ කොලේජ් ආයතනයේ ජාත්‍යන්තර පාසලක් විදිහට. ඕගලන් තමයි මේකේ බාරකාරීත්වය ඉස්සරහට බාර දෙලා තියෙන්නේ. දැන් මම හිටියෙත් නෑ උදේ. ඕගලන් තමයි උදේ පාන්දර ගිහිල්ලා මේ මරන් හිටපු සතු ටික මෙහෙම නිදාස් කරන එක ගැන අද ජාත්‍යන්තර පාසලක මුලින් මේක වෙනස්නේ. රජයේ පාසල් වලට වගේ නෙමෙයි ජාත්‍යන්තර පාසල් කියන්නේ සම්පූර්ණයෙන් වෙනස් විදිහකට යන්නේ. එතකොට ඕගලන් උදේ ඉඳන් අද දැන් මේ මොහොත වෙනකන් ඕගලන්ට ඕගලන්ගේ අතට මේ සතු ටික බාර දීම ගැන පතවාට ඔයාගේ හදවතටම එන පණිවිඩය මොකද කියන්නේ?
ගොඩක් සංවේදී. මොකද මහමෙවුනාවේ පින්න ස්වාමීන් වහන්සේලා හා ඉන්ටර්නැෂනල් ඉංග්‍රීස් ස්කූලේ එම මැඩම් සහ එම ගුරු ඇතුළු එම ශිෂ්‍ය පිරිස දෙනාගේම සහයෝගයෙන් අද දින උදෑසන පාන්දරම මහමෙවුනාවේ ස්වාමීන් වහන්සේලා සමග එම අද දින මරණ මංචකයට පෝරකයට අරගෙන යන්න තිබූ එළුවා 11 දින පොදව ගත්තා. ඒ වගේම විශාල වටිනාකමින් යුත් කිරි එළදෙනු. කිරි එළදෙනු අද දින ඒත් පෝරකයට යන අවස්ථාවේදී එයින් මුදවාගෙන අපට දෛනික ජීවිතයේ ආර්ථිකයේ වර්ධනය කර ගැනීම සඳහා අපේ ආර්ථිකයේ ගොඩනගා ගැනීම සඳහා අපට පරිත්‍යාග කිරීම පිළිබඳව විශේෂයෙන්ම මාමෙවුනාවේ පින්වත් ස්වාමීන් වහන්සේලාට ඉන්ටර්නැෂනල් විද්‍යාලයේ එම මැඩම් සහ එම ආචාර්ය මණ්ඩලය ඇතුළු සියලුම ශිෂ්‍ය දරුවන් දරු දෙවියන්ට පින් හා දීර්ඝායුෂ ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරමින් මෙම කුසල කර්ම චතුරාර්ය සත්‍ය අවබෝධ.
today is the 20th anniversary, the 20th celebration of Gateway College, and they have finally initiated a meritorious action, which is saving the animals which are sentenced to death. So in such situations, being an international school, unlike the other international schools, Gateway have taken a major description. Gateway has taken a much more step forward in doing this meritorious activity. Thank you so much for all the viewers out there who was joining, and also the entire crew, the teachers, starting from the chairman, Dr. Harshallers, the principals, the teachers, once again, the staff, support staff, everyone, and also the venerables who joined with us, and also the ShraddhaTV crew who joined with us in this memorable location. Thank you so much. I'm leaving today. We'll see you with another meritorious act very soon. Sadhu, sadhu.
Namo Buddhaya. The meritorious event of Shraddha Abhayadana, conducted at Gateway College, Nigambo, on 16th July 2016, to mark the 20th anniversary. May all rejoice in this meritorious event.